The Art of Emotions by Ryan Kuhn. Today I'll be discussing about the art of emotions, which I mean that art can actually alter your emotions and help you feel better or worse. Let's go straight into an example. It's kind of light, but in the picture, there's a man, and he's just sleeping there by his desk, and there's a huge trash pile in the back, as you might be able to see, and it seems to resemble Mount Everest, which your trash should not be able to do that. You should not have that much trash, and this man is being really lazy. When you think you're lazy, you're probably not as lazy as this. When you look at this, you probably don't feel half as bad about it because you're not this guy. What I mean is, looking at any form of art, like whether it's dance, literature, or just sketching, painting, well, looking at it can set different moods for you. Like if you look at a colorful painting, then you may feel better. Like if there are bright colors like yellow, blue, green, and other sorts of bright colors, then you will feel better, you'll feel upbeat. But then if you look at one, like if you look at a painting with a sad face, there's black and purple, lots of other dark blue colors, then you will not feel good. Also, if you look at a dance, like if you go to watch a musical, but like super sad, so like, I guess, let's say, for example, there's like a man and there's a woman and they're dating and then one dies and you're like, ooh, and then you're like, oh, and then the scene is like everybody's crying, then you're gonna feel kind of sad. But then if you watch one that has a lot of songs, everybody's happy, and they're bouncing around, then you wouldn't feel as sad as the one where someone goes through. And in literature, when you see like Shakespeare's plays, like, they all have dialogue and monologues like that are kind of serious and deep, and you'll kind of want to understand the world better, let's say, or you'll just feel sad, like the sad musical. Or if you see a play, it says Little Red Riding Hood, but she doesn't get eaten by a wolf or anything, then that'll be better for you, you'll feel happier, and nobody dies. And the reason why I think this is because I think it helps you feel better. I also did research on several websites where people can give their own opinions, like Quora and sometimes Wikipedia and other websites like that. And a lot, the majority of people agreed to my claim. And I also feel that people shouldn't feel bad all the time because that leads to depression, and depression is not good at all. And some more examples are, if you're feeling really down, but then you see like, if you feel like sad and useless after messing up something for your whole team, then you might want to see like a picture of, let's say, Superman. Like he's saving the world and stuff, right? So he will give you an example. He'll set an example for you. He'll be a role model. You'll want to be that person, absolutely. Like nobody wants to be a useless guy who's just in the corner, bench warmer. Nobody wants to be that person, unless you did. So, in conclusion, art, every branch, whether it's literature, dance, painting, or drawing, all can help you feel better or worse, depending on the theme, the mood, or anything else in the painting. My name is Ryan Kim, and thank you for listening to my presentation.